today we're going to be doing a reinstall of a cylinder head on a 5-liter LR4 vehicle. The vehicle's age is a 2012. This is the cylinder head we took and removed off of the engine due to severe mechanical damage due to the timing jumping. It bent all the valves in this cylinder head. It's been to the machine shop, now returned to us, and my job is to reinstall it back on the engine and ensure we get the timing correct and up and running again. We're just showing you the head on the bench right now. The exhaust manifold has been refitted. I'm going to be reinstalling it. You'll see it probably next when it's actually installed on the engine, as it's quite a heavy unit. Sometimes it can take two people to actually put the head back on the car with the exhaust manifold on, because it's kind of hefty, as it were. As you see, the cams are removed at this time. That is because the cylinder head bolts go through the cam carriers and the bearings go on top once the cam's reel installed. Of course, we can't put the head on and tighten it down with the cams in it. We'll do all of that, and I'll go through the process of tightening sequence and the two different types of cylinder head bolts that you may possibly have on your engine. Okay, so we have the cylinder head mounted to the engine at this point. It's mounted with the exhaust manifold on the cylinder head. Otherwise, you'll never get to get the manifold mounted with the head already mounted on it. There's 10 cylinder head bolts. It's an M10 cylinder head bolt. It's a stretch bolt. There is two different types of cylinder head bolts. There's an M11. There is difference in length of about 2 or 3 millimeters, and different in shape also. I've actually already tightened just run three bolts down. I'm going to run the rest down until they're all mated to the cylinder head surface, and then we're going to start with the cylinder head tightening sequence. As you can see, I've printed out the sheet here, starting in the middle of the cylinder head, 1, 2, 3, 4, working round the clock. The first stage of tightening is at 20 newton meters, 35 newton meters, third stage 90 degrees, the last stage, stage 4, 120 degrees. Right, so now I'm going to start off the first round of torque tightening. The torque wrench is set. I believe it was 20 newton meters, 35 newton meters. I'm going to start at the middle, number one, and then literally 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and we'll let it settle for a minute, and then start the second round at 35 newton meters, and then we'll start the torque angle procedure. So I'm at the stage where we're going to torque to 90 degrees. I have my degree wheel on, the tool locked in place, zero it out every time. We're going to turn to 90 degrees. It's a pretty straightforward job. I'm going to run them down to the first 90, let it sit for a couple of minutes, and then I'm going to run it down to the second. A final stage of stretch, which is 120 degrees, and we'll take off again when we get to the 120. We'll start with the 90 right now. Now we have 90 degrees. Take the tool out, start on the next bolt, and keep going round in the clockwise manner that it requests in the workshop manual. Okay, so the first stage of the stretch bolts was 90. I've covered all 10. I'm going to start the last and second stage of 120 degrees. and we'll video a couple. I'll go through the rest and we'll start off again when we're about to mount the camshafts. There's the first one at 120. I'm going to take it out and move it to the next step. So all 10 cylinder head bolts have been tightened down to Torx spec. We have the tool for the cylinder head bolts. It's kind of got a long shank on it. It is not quite a Torx bit. It's a special order. We carry them in stock here. It comes with the nylon sheath to stop any damage to the cylinder head. Especially when you're cranking on it, literally sits like that. Okay, so now the cylinder head bolts are tightened, we can install the camshafts. They're quite definable from side to side, intake and exhaust. Exhaust here, intake here, as you can see. It's got the extra lobes on it for the variable, the high lift on the intakes. I'm just gonna mount them in loosely for now, get the cam caps and tighten them down. Of course you can't torque the head until the cams are out, as you can see them installed through underneath the carriers for the bearings of the camshafts. So I'll install these loosely, put the caps on, and we'll torque them down to spec. So I'm going to run the bolts all the way down till they seat, just initial contact, and then I'm going to start to tighten them down evenly right the way across the camshaft so we don't have any issues with a tight cam or anything. And we'll take a quick break. I've got to get the specs for torquing of these screws, and we will be back. Okay, so both the cams are installed. They are pinched, not torque tightened yet. They're just pinched down into place. I loaded the cams in the head so that they were as close as they could be to being timed up. After I torque them, I'm gonna turn the cams manually, put the cam locks in, and then I'm going to start on the install of all the timing chains, tensioners, and guides. We've been through that before, but we can go over it again. The main thing was to show install of the cylinder head, torquing the head bolts, torquing in the new cam, well, the reinstalling of the cams and the cam caps. I've got to head up front to the office area, pick up the Torx specs for these, and then we'll be back and do a quick torque sequence of the camshafts. Okay, so the torque spec settings for these bearing cap screws are 11 newton meters, which is 8 pounds feet, and about 97 pounds inches. And the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, same on the exhaust caps, same torque specs. So I'm going to torque those down and then turn the cams so I can put the cam timing lock tools into position and then start building up the timing gears, put the variators on, put the chains on, and time up the engine. That's 11. The back ones are a little bit awkward to see and get to. There's 11. The front ones are easier to see and get the... There's 11. There's 11. A fraction over 12. Bit more difficult to see these back ones, but there. All set. So camshafts are all torque tightened to spec. Next thing I'm going to do is turn them, put the cam locks in, and again, like I say, start on timing up the cams. Need a mirror. Okay. That's pretty good. This is going to be the awkward one to get to. I've got to get that horizontal. Okay, so we just wanted to give you an idea of torquing the cylinder heads with the engine installed. The cylinder head I mounted a little bit prior, of course. You didn't actually see that. It's a little awkward, especially with the extra weight of the exhaust manifold on it, but it can be done. The torque specs again, 20 newton meters, 35 newton meters, 90 degrees, 120 degrees. Pretty straightforward. The cams are in and mounted, torqued to 11 newton meters, starting with the front bearing caps, working your way back. I've actually also already put in the cam lock, so the cams are timed, ready for the timing chains and variators to be installed. That's about all we have for mounting and installing the cylinder head. Pretty straightforward.